Hi there, welcome to Fact Friday. This week I want to talk about matching law versus behavior contrast. These are two terms that people often mix up or confuse, so let's just simplify them. Matching law states that relative response rate will match or be equal to relative reinforcement rate. So what does that mean exactly? Simply stated, given a choice of behavior to engage in, a person is more likely to choose the behavior that has the highest rate of reinforcement for them at that particular time. And you can understand that that timing can change. At any given moment, what's valuable or meaningful to us shifts. So this is also going to have something to do with the response requirements and available reinforcement. Obviously, harder work for something very meaningful versus less work for something less meaningful. So essentially, behavior goes towards reinforcement. So for example, having a drink or not having a drink. Those are two behaviors, right? So both of them are reinforcing for different reason. Drinking aids in having a good time, relaxation, being chill, while the other one doesn't do that, but it also doesn't cause a headache. It also could increase your productivity or objectivity. There's fewer calories. So you get it, right? On any given moment or at any given moment, what you're gonna find reinforcing is gonna shift. So on a Friday night, you choose the behavior that works for you at that particular moment. Maybe pre-exam, you're not drinking so much. Post-exam, maybe you get back to your partying ways. Matching law is associated with the concurrent schedule of reinforcement. Now, with this compound schedule, a client is given a choice of behaviors, each having their own specific reinforcement/reinforcement schedule. And the behavior that's chosen is usually the one with a more meaningful reinforcer or schedule. Now, behavior contrast, that's something different. That's a side effect of treatment. So when a behavior occurs in multiple environments, which most often it does, but your treatment is only implemented in one setting, you're only going to do the DRO, DRA, punishment, extinction in one of the environments in which the behavior occurs, you can expect to see a change in that behavior in the opposite direction in the non-treatment settings. You're going to see improvement in treatment, but the opposite of improvement. It's going to get worse in non-treatment. This is exclusive to multiple schedules of reinforcement. So for example, if you have one behavior that's being reinforced in school and that same behavior doesn't contact reinforcement at home or anywhere else, kind of like extinction, what's bound to happen? Well, the behavior at home is probably going to decrease even beyond what the baseline level was, even though nothing changed in the home setting. But the intervention in another setting contributed to progress in that setting, however, caused a decline in another setting. That is something to think about when planning your treatment packages for only one setting. I hope that helps, guys, and I hope to see you next time.